my time. I am so happy to be here. A few years ago, I got your award in my living room. And I never thought that I would be able to come here and meet you. So this is so great. All these students over there, you should come over here so I can see you. How about that? Yeah. Come on. I came to see the students so it'd be cool if you were not against the wall, but you were over here. Okay, so, you know that my name is Henry Winkler. You want to get closer? This is so great. And the parents are all dressed up. This is so cool. All right, so, my name is Henry. I was born in New York City. My parents were very, very, very short Germans. I went to PS 87, the same school that Hank Zipser goes to. I lived at 210 West 78th Street, the same building and apartment that Hank lives in. And then I went to McBurney School for Boys. And I am a husband, a father. I have three children, Jed, Zoe, and Max. We have two dogs. Charlotte is a Labradoodle. A Labrador and a poodle ran into each other. And then my wife found a little Labrador and brought him home, and he was so cute. And then he grew into a Great Dane. And his name is Linus, and we use him as a dining room table because this guy is big. I'm an actor, I am a producer, I'm a director. We have written 15 Hank Zipser novels, and I am in the bottom 3% academically in America. Yeah. It's unbelievable. The headmaster of my school, McBurney School for Boys, we wore a blue blazer, gray slacks, and a tie every day. And the headmaster said, "Winkler, I want to know why you're not achieving." I said, "Hey, that makes two of us." So he sent me to see a doctor. I talked to this doctor for about an hour, a talking doctor. And they said, "Son, you have to learn to focus." This was great. I knew what to do. So, you know, at the end of my block, I could buy highlighters. And I bought highlighters, and I went home and highlighted the Middle Ages. I had pink for plagues, blue for wars, green for dates. There was not one fact that was too small for me to highlight. I highlighted the entire book. I highlighted my desk. I redid my room and highlighted. But at the end of the day, it was still all Greek to me. I had no idea what I was writing. I had no idea what I was highlighting. I had no idea what I was reading. You know, when we read novels, everybody in my class, in my school, they wrote in the margins. I didn't know what they were writing, but I wanted to write in the margins too. They all had notes they were writing. And it was so smart. So I didn't know what they were writing. What I did was I dropped little drops of water on every page. And the book crinkled up, and it looked like I was using that book within an inch of its life. And then applying to college. Any other seniors here? Right? So you apply, what, to three schools? You apply to your first choice, your second, and your safety? I applied to 28 colleges. I got into two. I got into Park University in Missouri. I never have met anybody who has gone to Park University. I think it is a doorway on a prairie. I also got into Emerson College in Boston, and that's where I went. I nearly flunked out my first year, but I took so many tours around for the administration office for prospective students, for students that were thinking of coming to the college, they thought, "I'm a good guy. We're going to give him another shot." My parents, remember those very short German people? They had an affectionate phrase for me when I was growing up. They called me Dummhund. For those of you who don't speak German, that means dumb dog. Very supportive people. I'm not kidding. My parents, they didn't want me to be an actor. My father wanted me to take over the lumber business. He bought and sold wood. Now, I like a gym floor like anybody else, but I wanted to be an actor since I was 7. I don't know why. I just knew that that's what I wanted to do. My father spoke 11 languages. I had trouble with English. My mother could do math in her head. She could just figure stuff out. I took geometry, same course, 4 years in a row. My father spoke to me in those 11 languages every single day. He would say to me, "Why do you think I bought a business over here?" I said, "Besides being chased by the Nazis, Dad, was there a bigger reason than that?" Because I'm open. I want to hear it if there is. And then I graduated from college, and I got the nerve to apply to the Yale School of Drama. And I got a call in the last semester of college from Yale, and they said, "Would you like to join us at Yale in September?" I said, "Can I think about that?" "Yes, I would. I'd like to do that." And then I went to Yale, and I was sitting where you are, and the dean of students was talking to all of the students. He said, "Look to your right, look to your left. One of you will not be here next September." I went home and packed. I didn't even know this guy, and I thought he was talking directly to me. I was the king of negative thinking. I thought, I'll never graduate, I'll never get a job, she won't go out with me, the girl that I want to go out with. Every negative thought in the world was in my head, and I wanted to beat the system, and I started reading an Armenian philosopher.